I marvel that you're so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another. There be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that ye received, let him be accursed, or let him be damned. But in the final analysis, there's only two ways to be saved, or two schemes of salvation that is put forth by man. One scheme is that man saves himself, and the other scheme is that God saves a man. Those who teach that man saves himself may say that man saves himself by reforming his life and cleaning his life up before he's saved to merit salvation. Or they may say that man saves himself by promising to keep the Ten Commandments before he's saved. Or man saves himself by receiving the seven sacraments. Or man saves himself by obeying the gospel, whatever that means. Because there's only one definition of the gospel in the Bible, and you can't obey the gospel. The only thing you can do is believe the gospel. 1 Corinthians 15, the first four verses, Paul said, I declared unto you the gospel, how that Jesus died for our sins according to the Scriptures, how that he was buried, and how that he was raised from the dead the third day according to the Scriptures. That is the gospel. Romans 1:16, Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel, for it, the gospel, is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that behaves it. That's the unauthorized translation. To everyone that believes it. The only thing you can do with the gospel is believe it. The gospel is the good news of how Jesus came to this earth. How he died on a cross in your place for your sins. How that he was buried and was raised from the dead the third day. That's the gospel. Don't confuse the truth with the gospel. The gospel is the truth, but all truth is not the gospel. And it bothers me when people come along and throw the works of the mud of good works in the waters and muddy up the gospel of grace. It bothers me, and I almost feel like Paul to say, though we are an angel from heaven, preach unto you any other gospel, let him be damned. You say, that'd be awful strong. Yeah, but I can quote Paul, can I? I'd say, Paul said, if we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel, let him go to hell. Quiet in here. And yet there's something about humanity that makes us want to add something to the gospel. We want to help God out. If we can't help him save us, we want to help him to keep ourselves saved after we get saved. Just like Adam, when he realized he was naked, he went out and sewed fig leaves together. He knew something was wrong and he tried to write it. And before God made an appearance in the garden, his fig leaves were acceptable by Eve, and they were acceptable to himself. And they were happy with their fig leaf religion till God came. But when God came, they were embarrassed with their fig leaf religion, and they ran and hid themselves. And God killed an innocent animal, which is a picture of the substitutionary death of Jesus. And God skinned that animal and took the skins and made coats for Adam and Eve. And he didn't let them keep one single fig leaf of their own making. And you may be satisfied to stand before men with your religion. And you may say, I'm satisfied with my religion. But I want to ask you something. Are you going to still feel that way about it when you stand eyeball to eyeball with God Almighty, who put his son on a cross in your place and loaded him down with your sin and poured his wrath out on his own son so he could save you from the wrath of sin, which is hell? Are you going to feel satisfied to stand before God with a fig leaf religion that you have?